This here is a pharaonic statue of Horus, the sun and the falcon god, his real father Osiris in the middle, and his mother Isis to the right. And because Osiris, his sexual organ couldn't be found anymore, they put this symbolically on his head. Look very carefully on his head, the one in the middle. The main tool for a circumcision. Altogether forming the reason that his phallus couldn't be found anymore, or at least part of it. Just as the obelisk is a phallic symbol, and as it is carved on top, being a symbol for the circumcision, altogether the work of the penis worshippers, one could say. Inherited within the religious beliefs, it's absolutely forbidden to mutilate God's creation by cutting off a big chunk of a defenseless child. Now look at it very carefully here. We're gonna see it again in a minute. Just look at it carefully, these two things on his side. Well, here we can see it again, this thing that Osiris has on his head, the guy who couldn't find his sexual organ anymore. Well, here it is. And this is for removing the sexual organ, isn't it? Here it is, exactly the same thing. And there are many more sort of pictures of it. It's called the life cycle. So these are the circumcision tools. Well, hello Osiris, at least we know what you're wearing on your head now. A life cycle. And there are many more pictures to be found. Right bottom. So these are typical pharaonic tools still being used today. There it is. And it was indeed Seth, or Sethon, Seton, Satan, or Satan, or the devil himself. In most European countries, it's being pronounced as Satan, Sat-on, you know. So Satan, or the devil himself, who killed Osiris. The circumcision has pharaonic origins, and it was Sat-on's idea in the first place to mutilate the slaves, because when done so, the sexual desire starts at a very early age, around 10 years old, when the human brain has not entirely developed yet. Draining out nutritional liquids through the spinal column out of the brain at each ejaculation, thus creating perfect slaves with an undeveloped brain and interested in one thing only, as the lack of the foreskin creates a perpetual condition which a normal man would define as an erection when the glands shows. So this is an authentic pharaonic picture, so what do you think they're doing? Now what is he doing? Well, he's cutting it off, isn't he? Yeah, and here's something, he's showing it here, cut it off. There. Chuck. Cut off God's creation. Yeah. To convince the people, Sethon was very smart, using the powerful argument of fear, and said it to be more hygienic, whereas God created the skin just for those reasons, in fact, to protect from dirt coming in the most sacred parts of the internal side of the organ. This is how Sethon made the slaves and their desires very devoted and loyal to and controllable by Isis and her sisters. This is the true sense of this covenant or alliance with Sethon and Isis.